The pandemic could have a lasting impact on Bay Area transit as well. Tonight, AC Transit's board of directors heard a proposal to reduce service by 20%. KPIX5's Katie Nielsen looks at how agencies are trying to survive a historic loss in ridership.
BART just announced it's asking for another $500 million from the federal government to close a massive budget gap that was caused by a decrease in ridership, all due to the shelter-in-place orders. Many other transit agencies are facing the same issues. This is a common sight any day of the week. Empty trains. There's no such thing as a heavy commute for the time being.
We are going to come back. And public transportation is going to be just as important, if not more important, as we go forward after this crisis.
Malcolm Heineke is the former head of the SFMTA and Muni Board of Directors. He says every transit agency in the Bay Area is facing a massive budget shortfall when ridership ground to a halt due to the shelter-in-place orders.
And these challenges are particularly difficult for agencies that really depend on farebox revenue.
Farebox revenue is the amount of money collected directly from riders. According to planning documents, Caltrain gets 70% of their operating revenue from passengers. For BART, it's right around 60%, and for AC Transit, it's only 16%. The majority of their revenue comes from sales tax and parcel taxes, which are expected to be down significantly as well.
For the economy to recover, BART and public transit in general must be there.
All the major Bay Area transportation agencies got emergency funds from the CARES Act. But even that might not be enough. Now many are proposing cuts to service to help balance their budgets. SmartTrain might stop weekend service altogether. AC Transit is looking at a 20% reduction in services, and Caltrain could consider a full shutdown.
At this point in time, the goal is not to provide maximum service to the maximum amount of people. That is the normal goal. At this point in time, the goal is to provide service to those who absolutely need it.
The majority of the agencies have enough money to operate for the next couple of months, but after that, we'll either need an infusion of emergency funding or we'll have to make drastic cuts to services. In Dublin, Katie Nielsen, KPIX 5.